couple times, that's for sure.
Vera kicks it off. High short kick. Not going to kick it deep. Taken by one of the up men for the Aztecs. And San Diego State, who won the toss and elected to receive, is going to end up with good field position across the 40 up to the 42. And a flag comes in.
Yeah, EIU looked like they didn't want to kick it deep there and risk a return. Instead, they sky kick it. Nice little return, though, by the up man. And San Diego State, depending on this penalty, comes out with pretty good field position.
So Pumphrey, one of the up backs, catches the kick, gets a nice return. They get 15 more for a horse collar penalty. San Diego State won the toss. They took the ball first.
Yeah, you know, and this is going to be an interesting drive because last year on the first drive, they punted 8 times, turned the ball over 3 times, and only scored twice. So I want to see what they do right here.
Well, they'll start it at the Panther 44. Adam Dingwell is the quarterback, trying to set up a little screen, and does. Muima with the catch. He's strong and physical, and Muima takes 4 Panthers down to the 29.
Great job by Muima, weaving his way in and out of that Panther defense. I like the timing on the screen. You know, they open up most of their games with the run game. Threw him off a little bit there. Nice call.
Adam Muima, very big and powerful, 5'10", 205. Not blazing speed, but can work his way out of piles. In at 14, spotted at the 30. Well, maybe the thought was Rocky Long knows his defense is going to be really good. Give his offense a chance to try to get something going starting a game. And Muima stacked up the line, just 1.
Yeah, led in there by Chad Young, the fullback. A little bit of an iso pay. They loop the guard around.
Injured player down on the field. At 94, yeah, it's 94. Yeah. Quentin Copel's a senior. And Copel's still down on the grass. And he'll be tended to by the training staff.
Yeah, you hate to see that in the first drive, just the second play of the ball game right there. One of your guys goes down. Everybody's amped up.
We'll check the Aztec offense. Dingwell, the quarterback, started the second half of last season, entered the play against Nevada and led them to a come-from-behind overtime victory. Ruffin, very explosive, a wide receiver for San Diego State. Muima, the running back, we've seen number 4, and we'll see a lot more of him. So the known commodities for the Aztecs offense, Dingwell at quarterback, Muima at running back, and Ruffin has got some speed from the wide receiver spot. Some of the other pieces will have to be figured out. Is always part of the process, but they have a veteran in Bob Toledo. Good shot of him right there, former head coach at UCLA Tulane. He and Rocky Long worked together at UCLA. When Bob was the head coach, he hired Rocky to run the defense. When Rocky was head coach at New Mexico, he hired Bob to run the offense. And with Andy Ludwig taking the job at Wisconsin, Gary Anderson's new staff, he called Bob, and Bob said he had figured that after Tulane he was going to retire, call it good. He said, I've got a lot of energy, but I am 67. I wasn't going to hopscotch the country. And about the only guy I was going to work for was Rocky Long, he said. And my wife made a funny face when I took that call and said, we're back in it, aren't we? And Bob Toledo, a wonderful offensive mind.
Yeah.
All right, so Quentin Copel's being tended to and put on the cart. We will step aside and come back to Qualcomm. Just underway, the season opener for Eastern Illinois and San Diego State.
Player.
This is what college football fans have been waiting for all season long.
Timotheus Granger, the junior, injured for Eastern Illinois, and he will be taken off on the cart. Bad start for the Panthers. Another look here, Ted.
Yeah, left defensive end right there. He takes on the tight end, does a great job, but then the guard loops around, and you see him make contact there, and as he's going down, he puts his left hand out, and it looks like he's got a shoulder injury on that left side. Fell on it funny.
Second and 9 for San Diego State. So Granger exits for Eastern Illinois. Dingwell under center. Wimma handoff. And there's a little show of the power. Hit and then driving forward for 3 more.
He has outstanding center of gravity. This is a guy who really carries his lower body unit very well from the waist down. That's where you look for that power in a running back. And he's hard to knock off his feet. The coaching staff has talked about that. And you saw a little bit of an example of it right there. The extra yardage just on effort alone.
Third and 4, opening drive of the game. Wimma to the sideline. Chad Young will stay in at fullback and line up next to Dingwell in the shotgun. Four wides. And Dingwell looking deep. Leap. Tipped incomplete.
He had exactly what he wanted. Man coverage over there on the far side of the field.
Ruffin couldn't haul it in.
Nice throw by Dingwell. I thought he put it right where he needed to. Ruffin had the reach on the defender, but just couldn't bring it down as they were coming down there in the corner.
You know, Ruffin, their big play receiver. So they get everything they want except the catch for the score. And the senior Wes Fear comes on for the field goal. And this will be from 42. 41-yard. Fear, plenty of leg. And San Diego State wins the toss, takes the ball, and puts 3 on the board.
Nice little drive right there. It was supplemented by the penalty on the kickoff return. That put them on the other side of the 50-yard line. Gave them good starting field position. A couple nice little runs by Moema. Man, I tell you, it's tough right now for Coach Babers to see somebody like Granger go out on the second play of the ball game.
Well, now Eastern's going to get the football, and their offense really is the strength of this team, a prolific, high-scoring attack, a playoff team in the football championship subdivision last year, and ranked in the top 25 again this year.
Yeah, you're going to see a wide-open attack, a lot of wide receivers, the up-tempo game. They get up there and they run it fast. But other than Eric Laura, their 5 leading receivers from 2012 are all gone. So there are a lot of open spots on this roster right now. It'll be very interesting to see how quickly these receivers grow up.
Pendergrass back deep. And Fear, after knocking through the field goal, marches it off. A little open space and a good return up near the 30. So good field position. Pendergrass not afraid to put his nose in there.
Yeah, nice little job by Pendergrass. He saw the crease right there, didn't hesitate, hit it. Lowered his shoulder pads, was able to bounce off a couple tacklers and get some extra. Good field position for the Panthers to start out.
First offensive possession for Eastern Illinois. Garoppolo, 3,823 yards last season.
That's amazing.
And he'll sling it around on first down. Laura with the catch. Penalty marker down. Laura stretches it out for a gain of 5 as we check Eastern Illinois' starting lineup. Offensive line going to have their work cut out for them against a very aggressive and quick
offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay first down.
And the front 5 will have plenty of work to do.
It's an experienced offensive line. They bring back a lot of guys there. 4 out of the 5, or 3 out of the 5 starters.
Well, the penalty will back him up, and Garoppolo with a little shovel pass up the middle, and this will be a Nice gain for Eastern Illinois, and they'll get it up to the 35 spot. They just had it, so a nice little shovel pass in the middle to Taylor Duncan.
Yeah, two plays in a row right now. It looks like the Coach Baber is trying to take advantage of San Diego State's aggressiveness on defense. A little screen to the outside to Trips on the first play. Shovel pass inside with that outside pressure coming.
Aztecs defensively, a very aggressive team, and a handoff to Shepard. Little, who fumbles it.
Looks like his knee was down.
And indeed, they will say it's down. And they'll spot him back at the 46.
Panthers catch a break. A little bit of nerves right there on the first carry by the running back.
First down, and they snap it in a hurry. Garoppolo with a quick release. Drake with the catch over the middle. But Rocky Long wants to play around 22 players on defense. The question was, would they have enough time to shuffle all the people he wants to in and out with this fast attack? And another quick hitter right here to Shepard Little. And the fast pace of Eastern Illinois is looking every bit like the Oregon Ducks. Quickly over the ball, and a quick snap right there, and Garoppolo on third and one picks up the first down.
Yeah, right now the Aztecs can't keep up with that pace. They're not able to get people in and out. And the Panthers are getting the matchups that they're looking for. They're attacking that inside of the defense. I think they feel like there's so much pressure from the outside that there's some creases up the middle.
On first down, Garoppolo, another handoff, big hole. Taylor Duncan running strong down near the 35.
Taylor Duncan is the big back of their two. Shepard Little, a little more shifty and quickness, a little more speed.
We were told they were quick. But this is something, and a wide open Laura makes the catch for the touchdown. Garoppolo to Laura, and they're picking up in 2013 where they left off a season ago.
Pump fake, they had man coverage down here. Great job by Laura, a little stutter fake there. Tremendous separation from the corner, and he laid it right down on him. Watch him pump, and then he just lays it up. Laura runs right underneath it, doesn't break stride. And the Panthers are on the board.
And he beats Tony Bell, and that 1-2 combination with the strike for the score. Two-sport athlete Cameron Barra on for the PAT, and Eastern Illinois settling down on the road. They take their first offensive possession and cash it in for 7, 11-14 to go in the first quarter. The Panthers of Eastern Illinois leading San Diego State 7-3.
Oh, they're making me laugh.
Make my day.
Oh, yeah, I got to do it all? Okay.
Go ahead.
I did forget that. Go ahead. Make my day.
Welcome back to San Diego. Rich Cellini, Ted Sundquist in the Aztec student section, sitting down, perhaps a bit stunned.
A little bit. Nothing will settle your nerves, though, if you're on the other side with the Panther crowd than scoring on your first possession. They obviously saw something early on that they felt like they could attack the inside of that Aztec defense. One of the things that you don't see from a sideline angle is the line splits and a spread option attack. They're going to be a little bit wider than what you're normally used to seeing in, let's say, a tight end or two tight end set. And as you spread out those defenders in a 3-3-5, that's a lot of area those front three defensive linemen have to cover. And all it takes is just a little quick break, and you saw both running backs have some success on the inside moving the football.
Taylor Kerr is going to kick off. First time they tried the short safe kick. Didn't work out so well, and this time they'll try it again, but this will be a low hopper on the ground fielded by one of the Aztec up backs. It looks to be number 40, Chad Young, and he a decent field position again, so Eastern Illinois not wanting to let San Diego State get out in space.
Yeah, you're darned if you do and darned if you don't in this particular case. I mean, you kick it deep, and the return back to the 39-yard line is a pretty good return, and then you kick it with a squib or a sky kick, and they return it to the 40-yard line, and guess what? You got a pretty good return.
Second offensive possession. From the eye, Dingwell going to go to the air. That'll settle him down. Gets a nice completion out there to Ruffin, who makes somebody miss. Solid gain on first down.
Yeah, Dingwell's got to do that. He's got to spread the ball around, take care of it personally, but just spread the ball around and let his playmakers make some plays. He's got some big wide receivers in that core there. They're all 6 foot plus. Nice size to throw to. They've got good catching radiuses.
Dingwell 4-1 is the Aztec starter. Also mentioned he got that replacement gig at Nevada last year, and that really jump-started their entire season. To come from behind, win on the road, and they capture it in overtime. From that point forward, San Diego State didn't lose. They won their final 7 games.
Yeah, it really did. It gave the offense not only confidence, but the entire football team confidence that he could be the guy that would ultimately replace Ryan Lindley, and he did just that. They got on that 7-game roll like you talked about, and finished with one of their better seasons in school history.
Yeah, they had Ryan Katz in the fold, too, at that point, and so you're just trying to figure out where you want to go with it, because Lindley was here for so long, starting those 4 years. It seemed like, you know, played for 4 years at a university. It feels like you played for a decade.
No doubt.
3rd-and-1. Muema searches his way, and there's a good example right there, Ted, of what you talked about before we even went on, about a guy who can gain yardage when he's in the pile.
You're exactly right, Rich, and the Panthers did a great job on 3rd-and-short getting penetration, and they had him in the backfield. Actually, the first man stood him up on the other side of the line of scrimmage, but he kept his feet moving. He's got that strong lower unit, and he was able to push forward for an extra yard or two, convert the first down.
Second possession for the Aztecs, second time they've been in Panther territory. They got 3 with their opening possession. Eastern Illinois got the touchdown. And here's a Bob Toledo special. He likes to call these exotics. Lockett on the little end around, trying to get into Chase, and they overcommitted, and Lockett is out in front. Touchdown, Aztecs!
That shows you right there the kind of athleticism, quickness, and speed that Colin Lockett brings to the Aztec offense. That Panther defense had him bottled up. They read the reverse really well, I thought. But he was able to hesitate for a second, get them to freeze, and then turn on the Jets. Big, big play. Watch him right there. Just freeze the defenders and then uses that all-out speed. Takes it to the house.
PAT attempt is good as Fear knocks it through, and the Aztecs now on top 10-7.
I'll tell you what, Rich, that's what we call in NFL scouting stop-start acceleration, the ability to stop after a full dead sprint and then accelerate again. And he was able to outrun that entire Panther defense.
Bob Toledo, offensive coordinator, visiting with Lockett and the offense. So Bob Toledo not afraid to go deep into a playbook. You talk to him about, you know, exotics, as he calls them. People call them trick plays. Bob says, you know what, they serve a purpose. It gives defenses things to think about. He said when they're executed well, he said they're a lot of fun for the kids. They like to talk about them. They like to think about them. He said, this needs to be fun. I mean, it's a sport that we play for enjoyment. He said, and the young guys love to play it, so let's do some things that are fun. And when you get a nice little reverse out of it, you get a touchdown. He says, now that's just another something for defensive coordinators to have to ponder.
Hey, no doubt. And timing has so much to do with it as well. And the Panthers are feeling pretty good. They go down and drive and score on their first possession. They're up 7-3. The defense is playing aggressively. And they over-pursue to the left, come back with a reverse to the defense's right. And Lockett's able to use that all-out speed to beat EIU.
And Fierce kick will roll out of the side of the end zone. Panthers will get the ball at 20.
You know, I mean, I think you're going to see a lot of that out of the San Diego State offense this year. Those big plays, those long plays that we saw a couple years ago with Ronnie Hillman and Vincent Brown, those guys. I mean, just explosive playmakers.
Talking about two NFL players, Hillman in Denver. Vincent Brown got to stay home right here with the Chargers. Well, what's the answer right now defensively for San Diego State against this offense?
Well, I tell you what, they got to get some more penetration, I think, up front. Right now they're trying to keep the quarterback in the pocket, obviously, and they're bringing it off the edge, but they're opening up the middle too much. And the Panthers are able to read that. A lot of it's been predetermined, at least early on, but they've been able to read that and attack that soft middle.
Three wide receivers in the bunch at the bottom of your screen. Instead, Garoppolo going to do it himself, and he's got some good wheels. And this used to be the home of the Padres back in the days when it was Jack Murphy Stadium. So he slides in looking like Tim Flannery. There's a good old Padre for you.
Not Tony Gwynn.
No, not Tony Gwynn. Tony would have stole the base. Tony's the head coach of the Aztecs. Had a great baseball season. Won the Mountain West Tournament. Advanced to the NCAAs. Mr. San Diego. Garoppolo. In trouble. Has to try to throw it away and does.
Was looking to the inside on that little shovel pass again. They're trying to neutralize San Diego State's defense by spreading them out with two bunch formations. Here they are again. One to the top, one to the bottom.
Well, now look at this one. The 3-3 and a flag. A procedure penalty.
I'll tell you what, I think we had a little trickery getting set up right there,
agreed,
too.
Agreed, because that was lateral. You're right.
Little stutter go pass.
False start. Number 86, offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Rex Bonham. Yeah, that may have been, you guys do a reverse, watch this. We know how to do a little something in the Ohio Valley. Second and 15. Directing traffic, plenty of time. High pass, tipped and incomplete. Gober couldn't reel it in.
Yeah, that's one of the things I want to watch in Garoppolo, and that is when his primary receiver is covered or the play breaks down, where does he go next? Does he have the patience? Does he have the poise to sit back there in the pocket?
Third and long, 15 to go for a first down. Garoppolo checks off, pressured again. And he keeps throwing them, but he keeps throwing them to his own sideline.
Yeah, that time San Diego State bought the blitz down here at the bottom of the field. Instead of rushing three, actually had four coming at him. Garoppolo does the right thing, throws it away instead of trying to force it down here.
Vizzy back deep. It's Weatherford on to punt. Well, the Aztecs adjusted nicely defensively. And the Panthers get the punt away. Good punt. And Vizzy has to make the fair catch at the 21. San Diego State ball when we come back. 8:28 to go in the first quarter at Qualcomm. Plenty to cheer about for the home team. San Diego State leading 10-7, and the Aztecs get the ball back. Everybody gets excited for the start of college football.
No doubt. It's been a great day today. Watch some of the games this afternoon. You know that word pageantry, you always think, what does pageantry mean? Well, I tell you what, there was a lot of pageantry today on the opening day. I mean,
wonderful traditions in the sport of college football. And as you talked about in the open, with the NFL not getting going really until, you know, Thursday, and then the weekend, you know, college football gets to own this weekend, and, you know, games Thursday, Friday, obviously traditional Saturday, and even some good ones on Sunday, especially in your state, Colorado, Colorado State. So
yeah,
Pac-12 against the Mountain West.
Big one, Rams and the Buffs.
Worst starting field position of the afternoon for the Aztecs, Dingwell. And Muema, a handoff, and he's stacked up the line. So we saw it on Eastern Illinois' last possession, and now on that first carry, it seems everybody's settling down.
Just a little bit. That defensive front now, I think, is playing a little more confident, standing up the blocks. Really kind of impressed so far with how the Panthers have stood toe-to-toe with the Aztec offensive line. Those are some big boys up there, 300-plus across the front.
No gain. Dingwell looking deep and going that way. Ruffin turns around and hauls it in. He's down inside the 30.
Little play action pass. They ran the ball early on. Ruffin does a little skinny post. Finds a seam between the defenders and goes up. That's a tremendous adjustment to a ball that was behind him, and that's what these receivers can do for San Diego State.
Ezell Ruffin, the big play man. They weren't kidding. Wemma picking his way. And the white shirts now have an eye out for Wemma, wearing number 4 in black.
Yeah, this defensive front for the Panthers is really flowing with action.
Well, the last possession was the touchdown on the reverse.
Yeah,
maybe flowing a little too much.
Yeah, exactly. It makes me think that any kind of a cutback or a zone type play leaves them susceptible. So look for Moema maybe to look backside.
Second and 12. Price now in as the deep back. Dingwell, wide open receiver, incomplete off the hands of the senior Lockett. Oh, you'd like to have that one back.
No doubt, again, a little bit of play action. He had set the defender up, made a little inside move, cut back to the out, hit him right in the hands. Sets up third and long. Those are the types of plays that a captain on that offensive side has got to convert.
Yeah, Lockett, 58 catches as a sophomore, just 20 as a junior, looking for a big bounce back here as a senior. Not off to a good start. Third and 12 following the incompletion. Four wides. Dingwell going to look to try to do it himself. Slips a tackler and gets right near the sticks and gets plowed. Looks like he's a yard short.
Outstanding effort by the quarterback. He can run too. We saw Garoppolo on the last drive take off and run. Dingwell's got a set of wheels as well.
Fourth down. And here comes a heavy package. Aztec's going to put some big bodies in. Play clock at 10. Price the deep back, Young the fullback. And Dingwell raises up and calls timeout. So not going to go for it on fourth and one, just trying to draw Eastern Illinois off sides.
Well, it'll be interesting to see. You know, I wouldn't disagree with them going for it right now. They've got that big offensive line. They've got the power fullback, and they just turn around and make a statement. Panthers have done a good job thus far in creating a little bit of penetration on the inside run game.
Well, you know, you may be right.
Maybe it was just an opportunity where he couldn't get it off. And, you know, Bob Toledo and company, they're still huddled up there, so still very much looking like they are going to go for it on fourth and one. I thought they were just trying to fake him out and going to send the field goal unit out.
Well, I tell you what, situations like this, I think, send a message to your football team that we have the faith in you that in fourth and one, in the opening week, we can convert down here. San Diego State was one of the better teams in the red zone last year, not only in the Mountain West Conference, but in the nation. Converted 90% of their red zone trips into scores.
Well, same package comes out. Price and Young in an eye. Fourth and one, and it's Dingwell trying to muscle his way over the left side behind the seniors Gordon and Quigley.
Looks like he's got it.
Indeed he does.
Nice job right there on the play side linebacker. That's just body on body. The big hog Molly's pushing him back. In a game like this, you got to expect if you're Bob Toledo that you're going to convert.
First down. Price, the shiftier of the backs, hits the hole hard and picks up a couple.
Yeah, it's interesting here with Price and Moema. You've got kind of a 1-2 punch right there. You're exactly right. You see a little bit more explosive quickness a la Ronnie Hillman. Moema, more of the power guy, hard to knock off his feet. Well, you like having that when you're an offensive coordinator.
Ground again on second and nine. Price spinning and pulled down to the turf. Good tackle by Jordan Wickliffe. The start of the season last year as a wide receiver got switched over to DB. Ended up with 76 tackles and a couple of interceptions. He made that transition seamless.
Outstanding transition. A lot of times it's very hard to find an offensive guy on the perimeter that wants to hit anybody. And to transition him over to the defensive side and make that many tackles. And right there, I tell you what, if he hadn't made that stop, they had the outside corner.
Good sheer tackle by Wickliffe to make it third down and nine. Dingwell all day, no pressure, and it's dropped. Tried to dump it down and it was dropped. Second drop on this drive. Speller right there and just couldn't hold it.
Look at the protection up front. Outstanding job shifting their feet. Nobody in Dingwell's face. Reads his first, second receiver, then dumps it off to his third option. That's, and he just flat dropped it.
Yeah, visiting the senior right over the middle, trying to make something happen before he secured the ball. Here from 35. Aztecs have scored on every possession. A touchdown and now a couple of field goals. Well, you like to have seven instead of three, but still productive.
Well, I like the fact that they went for it down there on fourth and one. And again, I say it shows the confidence that Coach Bob Toledo has got in that offensive unit that they can convert in those types of situations and gives them an opportunity to do it early in the season. They're going to be going up against some more vaunted defenses down the road, and they're going to have to come up with that play.
Well, next up for San Diego State and their marching band, a trip to Columbus.
Ooh, they won big today, too.
To play the Buckeyes, who are pretty darn good.
Not a bad football team, sitting at number two behind Alabama right now. They got off to a good start today.
That'd be a great trip for San Diego State and all the kids to go to the Big Ten and one of the great traditional powerhouses in college football. What an opportunity for the Aztecs.
And I tell you what, as an old Mountain West Conference / WAC guy myself, I love those games because sure. I think it gives an opportunity for our conference to go out and show people that we can play football out here in the West. And how many times have teams from our conferences gone out and knocked on those doors? At times beat them down.
Fear going to kick it deep. And bobbled in the end zone. And this wise move by the Eastern Illinois by returner Trey Pendergrass to take the knee.
Fear's done a good job here in the first quarter with his kicking responsibilities. Seamus McMorrow has been the guy in the past, but he's had a little bit of a quad injury over the course of camp. And they just had an all-out competition and a battle at the punter and the place kicker position. Fear comes in and converts on a couple field goals, kicks one into the end zone right there. Good job by the special teamer.
Yeah, did a nice job before getting that one to kick out of the corner of the end zone. So played well, Garoppolo. And the offense sputtered last time out. Plenty of time, looking for a home run ball down the right sideline. Caught! Caught and then punched out. And then the Aztecs have it. Gober had it for a moment, had it punched out. And San Diego State, who had 26 turnovers a season ago, comes up with another big one here early. Nate Burhe down there.
Boy, Garoppolo has all day. They only rush three. Look at him just sit back in the pocket. He's got a nice arm, puts it up just a little underthrown. The safety was late coming over to support the corner, but they were able to knock it out. Burhe makes the big recovery.
Kazee was right in there, the freshman, coming by to pop it out, saw an opportunity. So a big completion for Eastern Illinois ends up in a turnover.
Ultimately, it works out like a long punt, but you hate to do that on first and 10.
Aztec offense back on the field. And Dingwell going to try to answer with the long ball of his own. Nobody home. The Lockett, well, was the intended receiver, had broken into a post, and Dingwell was throwing it to the outside.
Yeah, certainly some confusion there on the route. That's going to happen early on, especially in week one. You're going to see a lot of these little wrinkles have to get ironed out. The timing. You cannot recreate game speed in a scrimmage or in a practice or in a 9-on-7 or a 7-on-7. The only way that you can get used to it is to actually play.
Safe pass on second and 10, tipped, incomplete. Judge, the freshman out there, pass a little high for him.
Great job on the interior of the Panther defensive line pressuring Dingwell. Somebody broke free, hit him right in the chops, forced him to throw that ball, I think, a little sooner than he wanted to. Wasn't able to step into the throw. Nice coverage as well at the point. Big third down.
Third and 10. Flags and a free play. And Dingwell just tosses that one into the dirt, knowing that he got the Panthers to jump.
Good job by Dingwell. He talked about that a little bit.
Number 97 defense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
He talked about a little bit about that in the preseason, about his presence and what Bob Toledo expects out of him when he comes up to the offensive line, his ability to use the cadence count, get them to jump off sides, his freedom to audible. Reduces it down from third and 10 to third and 5, a little more manageable.
Percentages go up on this one. Dingwell. Surveying, pressured, escapes one, but not the second. Ball popped out, and Dingwell has to fall on it. Now, say he was down. They came out with the football. But they'll say he was down, and Aztecs will punt.
Look at the protection he's got right here. I'd like to see him sit in the pocket a little longer. He flushes out too quickly, puts himself out in harm's way. Defender that had dropped into coverage then came up, made the initial hit. I think if he would just hang in the pocket a little bit longer, then some of the routes may have opened up for him.
Elise's punt, good one. Fair catch called for and made back near the 40.
Shepard Little, number 21 for the Panthers with the ball.
Little with a nice catch.
Aztecs unable to do anything off the turnover. Good punt, good coverage. Panthers got pretty good field position now.
Panthers just over first and 10 at the 41.
First drive was fast and furious, and San Diego State couldn't keep up with them. Since then, the offense has been slowed. First down, little shovel pass in the middle, and little boy, see something. And Shepard Little finally spun down, but not before he rips off a gain of 15.
Boy, I tell you, Derek Largent, his cleats were stuck in the ground right there. Little put a little juke on him right there, and the linebacker missed in the open field.
Garoppolo moving pocket, throwing one on the run. Laura out of bounds. Caught the ball, couldn't keep his foot down.
Yeah, nice roll right. I like the pattern. Everything about it, boy, that had pro written all over it. He tried to get those 2 feet down, extended outside.
Little again, quickly up the middle. And quick hitters, especially in the run game, have been effective.
They really have, right up the gut. They've spread them out. I think that, again, those offensive line splits are a little bit wider than what we're seeing here in this shot.
Panthers quickly over the ball. Garoppolo pitch out, caught, spun down. Good job completing the pass, just nowhere to run.
Yeah, this will be interesting. Fourth down and three. It looks like they're going to go for it.
Meyer got the catch. And indeed, they're lined up. And Garoppolo going to direct a little traffic. Home crowd cheering on the Aztec defense. Garoppolo trying to go down the sideline on fourth and three. Incomplete. Gober was out there. He pulled up the route. Garoppolo tried to hit him on the streak down the sideline. San Diego State ball, turnover on downs.
Yeah, Aztecs brought blitz off the backside. He had man coverage. Man coverage on the route at the top. A little bit of a misread right there. Receiver came back for the ball. Panthers end up turning it over on downs.
See what Bob Toledo goes to on those laminated sheets of paper. And with his decades of experience, boy, does he have a few play calls underneath his belt.
And no doubt there have been some chances for some big plays. We just dropped the ball here in the first quarter.
And on first down, safe one, incomplete. Off the hands of the fullback. Chad Young, the senior. Former walk-on who's earned a scholarship, very hard-nosed player. And San Diego State, whether it's a receiver or now a fullback, a few cases of the drops.
Yeah, a little bit. So you still have some nerves well into the first quarter with 2:07 to go. You know, Dingwell, I think, is just trying to manage the game, spread the ball around, put it in the hands of his playmakers, let them turn up and make something in the open field. They haven't been able to complete the pass.
Well, on second and 10 with a nice move. Hit from behind, but he'll fall forward for a gain of 6.
Nice little stretch play to the right. You saw him stop right there and then cut back. That's what I'm talking about, that over pursuit of the EIU defense allowed him to cut it back up under for an extra 4 yards.
At the 41 for the Aztecs.
And the official quickly over the ball, now backs out. Third and 4. Minute and a half to go, first quarter. And then flag comes in. Procedure.
Looks like some movement on the left side of the line there.
Offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
And Quigley, the senior, ticketed with that one, and that turns third and 4 into third and 9. Those hurt.
Yeah, they really do. And this time of year, once again, you're going to expect that with the speed of the game and just trying to get used to being under center. But those are the types of mistakes that you can't be making 2, 3, 4 weeks down the road.
Dingwell with time. Intercepted. They pick him off, and they're bringing it back the other way. McNulty with room, and he's out of bounds at the 25. Flag down as well. Flag back at the 35.
Some inside pressure by that Panther defense, I think, made Dingwell throw the ball before he wanted to.
After the interception, illegal block in the back on number 30 of the defense. Penalty to be enforced 10 yards from the end of the run. First down, Eastern Illinois.
And so Haynes with the illegal block in the back, but Eastern Illinois gets the turnover and will have good field position in Aztec territory. Rocky Long, head coach, Mountain West Conference Coach of the Year during his time at New Mexico, and now at San Diego State, got another Coach of the Year award last year. Another look at the pick.
Yeah, there was this inside spin move, and Dingwell had pressure in his face and ended up throwing before he wanted to. The ball went behind the receiver. McNulty did a great job breaking on it. The receiver never had a chance.
Running one up the middle on first down. Gain of four on the quick hitting play for Taylor Duncan. Duncan and Little have gotten it done, and they'll try it again. And number 14, Duncan, with another carry. Aztec saying the ball popped out.
Well, I see a helmet.
Officials still digging underneath there.
Looks like it's Panther football.
Yep.
Boy, they see something inside there, Rich, that they feel like they can attack, and they just keep going at it. I just feel like it's the line splits that have them, the Aztec defense, so spread out. Look at the distance there between the nose tackle and the two defensive ends.
Flags down, free play. Incomplete pass, direction of Gober. I think the Aztecs may have jumped, and if so, that'll be a first down for the Panthers.
What that's gonna do is it's gonna force the linebackers to step up inside in the gaps. And it's going to open up some of the inside of the football
defense.
Field there.
5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Jake Feely, the junior linebacker, had 90 tackles a season ago and 7 sacks, trying to shoot that gap a little bit too quick. Instead of getting in there making the play on third down, he instead gives Eastern Illinois a first down. Again, Duncan patiently picks his way to the 30.
Yeah, these aren't reads. This is not a read option. This is a predetermined give all the way. They obviously see something on the inside right now that they've been able to exploit.
And they have taken advantage. Good drive following the turnover off the interception, and we're at the end of the first quarter here at Qualcomm. San Diego State with the lead, 13-7. We'll be back with more college football from Qualcomm Stadium and the start of the second quarter coming up on the Mountain West Network.
You want answers? You know, I need someone to give it back to me.
You want the truth? You can't handle the truth.
You can't handle the truth. The truth is, you need me on that wall.
So you're saying there's a chance.
Tell me I've led a good life. Tell me I'm a good man.
All right, Spielberg gonna call me and
I have a pool and a pond. Pond would be good for you.
Stay classy, San Diego. Awesome. You guys are killing me with this stuff.
I don't watch movies. I'm a football coach.
At places and parties that you don't want to talk about, you want me on that wall. You need me on that wall.
Oh, yeah, I got to do it all? Okay.
Okay. I did forget that.
Go ahead. Make my day.
What do you got here, a 6-week training program? Well, that's perfect for me. John Candy's, one of his famous lines. Swallowed a bunch of aggression.
It's gotta be Wedding Crashers, but there's a thousand to choose from.
John, I was first team all state. I can put the ball wherever I want. I'll make it rain out here.
So you gotta ask yourself, do you feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Eddie, if I woke up tomorrow with my head sewn to the carpet, I wouldn't be more surprised than I am right now.
Welcome back to San Diego. Rich Cellini, Ted Sundquist on the Mountain West Network, powered by Campus Insiders. Second down and six as we flip sides of the field to start the second quarter. Lights on here at Qualcomm, and Garoppolo with a strike to Gober. First down, Eastern Illinois.
Nice little dig route in there. Good timing. A lot of this wide receiver core is new, so he's having to get used to them.
Garoppolo handoff, Duncan. Well, he is a nifty runner.
And he has a feel for that inside crease, and he doesn't overcommit. He's got takes little steps on the inside, which allows him to then shift his weight, and once he sees something open up, is able to quickly move his body in that direction.
And second and six, trying it again. Sheds one Aztec tackler, stood up. And he'll just get one on that one. So third and five coming up for the Panthers.
Now the counter to that is what you just saw. Sometimes when you get in there and you're tiptoeing a little bit, waiting for that right cut, you're gonna get stood up.
Four wide receivers, three go left on top of the screen. And Garoppolo throws a strike to Laura, who falls forward inside the five.
Quick slant, great job by the back, picking up pressure off the edge. Nobody on that inside of the defense, wide open.
First and goal. Garoppolo for Laura, touchdown Panthers. Second time tonight they've hooked up. Two straight. I'm not sure how you lose number eight. 136 receptions last season.
Absolutely incredible. And what you saw in that play right there was something that they've practiced time after time after time after time.
Yeah, that doesn't happen on the third try. They knew exactly where they wanted to go with it and what they wanted to do.
So far, those young corners for the Aztec defense are bending a little bit, and they're breaking.
Well, we talked about the nine starters returning. The spots who didn't were the cornerbacks. So the two corners, the new ones, and that's easy. 1-2, that even counts on, that counts tomorrow as well.
Did a great job laying it up over the outside shoulder.
Barra missed it. Vera missed the PAT, and we stay tied at 13. Rare miss for the senior Cameron Barra, who's an outstanding two-sport athlete. Last season, he was 12 of 13 on field goals, then batted 300 and started in right field for the Panthers.
Well, one of the things that we didn't discuss in the pregame was that the Panthers are starting at long snapper a true freshman in A.J. Hantak, and you never know. I mean, sometimes the timing there is just as important as it is on that pass down in the end zone to make the touchdown. If that ball just off a little bit for the holder, something as easy as a PAT can go awry, and we're tied up now.
That's just really nice teamwork right there by a pair of players who are on the Walter Payton Award watch list and for the football championship subdivision, formerly known as 1AA football. For the older folks out there, that is the equivalent of the Heisman Trophy.
I can't keep up with it anymore. It's crazy.
You don't have to. I'll give you all the versions of it. If they change it, then I'll give you all three moving forward.
I tell you what, football is football.
And it's a good program, Eastern Illinois.
It really is. I've been impressed so far with what I've seen.
Aztec's sneaking up a little bit, and the Panthers going to do it again. This one a slower roller, almost trying to get it, looked like in between the two sets of linemen, and then have a sprint for the ball and see if they couldn't get on top of it. But San Diego State and Stan Sedberry able to get back that quickly and fall on top of that. Almost looked like it was planned to maybe get the ball back.
Yeah, I think so. I think that's exactly what they were trying to do, was spread them out a little bit, kick it into the soft area there of the return team, and perhaps win the scrum. But you know what Eastern Illinois has done on their kickoff coverage every time now has given San Diego State excellent field position. I think I just kick it away.
I agree. And with that excellent field position, and here's another one from their own 41, And they'll go to the air to start out with, and Lockett will get the catch and turn up field and get it into Panther territory. Now, from a scoring standpoint, Ted, you look at this. Instead of having to put together, get a chunk and get five, six, or seven plays to get in field goal range, you're giving a team an opportunity to make three or four plays and get in field goal range and get three more points on you.
Exactly, and with those big play wide receivers that San Diego State's got, and we've seen with Dingwell's arm, all it takes is one play to put them in red zone territory.
Moema looking for room, left side, across the 40, down to the 39.
Well, that was a really good looking play in the blocking up front. The Aztec offensive line did a great job sealing off that edge.
Well, another injured Panther down, another look.
Look at him right there. They pull around both the left guard, or right guard and right tackle to the left and seal off that side.
Nick Beard, 28, the senior and all Ohio Valley safety, led the team with 62 solo tackles last year, is down.
Yeah, 9 pass breakups. He is a big part of that Panther defense that returned 3 of 4 starters in the secondary. If he were to go down, that would be a big blow for Coach Babers in that defense. Looks like he's all right, jumped up there, shaking it off a little bit.
He'll get trip to the sideline, see if he can come back. But you need those guys, especially on the road, to keep everything calm. I mean, and they've done a nice job. You know, they did a little tribute to Hoosiers coming in here and playing in an NFL stadium. They're going to get to play another NFL stadium, LP Field, in Nashville, home of the Tennessee Titans, later this year. But this is a really, you know, place you watch on TV a lot. You think of all the great history and the great games here, and then all of a sudden you're from the Ohio Valley Conference thinking, wow, I'm in an NFL stadium. What a neat opportunity.
I tell you what, I won my first Super Bowl ring in this stadium.
That's right, against the Packers. There you go. Moema.
Hand off.
In a game that, I might add, you guys couldn't win. If you read everything reading up to it, there was not a lot of love given to the men from Denver.
It just goes to show you that the game has got to be played. It's not played on paper. Same thing with this one. We talked about the importance of the Aztecs taking the Panthers seriously. They earned the right to be here.
And Eastern Illinois doing exactly what you want to do on the road, regardless of your level of play within the NCAA, and that stick around, and they've done that, tied at 13. And they've bent a little bit. Moema pitches behind him. He tries to reverse his field, slips a tackle. One, now two. Now corralled, circled, and dropped. Loss of about 13 or 14 on it.
Well, I think he did that one on his own, Rich. He started right. Great job of flow with that defensive front. There really wasn't anything there. He thought he'd reverse his field. I talked about that there might be a cutback. But really, once he decided to go that direction, it was too late. Secondary had pursued, and big, big loss.
Loss of 12. Well, even if you have a thick playbook like Bob Toledo, there's not a lot for second and 22. Let's get a piece of it back. Bobbled snap, handoff, safe play, and Price getting some work done for the Aztecs. Still going to be third and long as he stopped right at the 35. Jordan Wickliffe with another sure tackle. Boy, he's good in the open field.
He really is, and I like this combination of Moema and Price. I mean, Moema brings that power that we talked about. They stand the pile up, and then he squirts out of there, that low center of gravity, hard to knock off his feet. But Price is the explosive guy. Once he gets into the open field, he can make you miss and turn a 3-yard gain into a 13, 14-yard gain.
Third and 13. Dingwell pressured, buys a little time, flag down, pass is complete to Denso. He'll be right near the sticks. We'll check the penalty flag at the 42. Greg Burks, our referee.
Holy, number 56 offense, 10-yard penalty, third down.
And the freshman Siragusa starting on the line. huge upside, but a freshman-type mistake.
Yeah, no doubt, and I think he got beat on an initial spin move on the inside. I've seen that so far. That center guard combination appears to be where the Panthers have been able to make their most pressure. On the outside, the tackles are running them by, but they've been able to do some counter moves on the inside, really break free. And when that pressure comes up the middle, I mean, it's right in Dingwell's face.
Well, San Diego State going the wrong way. Now third and 23. And Dingwell going to try to hit the check down to Price. Can't connect.
Yeah, that was probably the smart move. I was watching the three receivers deep. EIU did a good job in the secondary, just kind of keeping them underneath there, not letting anybody get by the deepest man.
Little back, waiting inside the 10. Pressure, and Alisi gets it away. And good coverage for San Diego State, and the Aztecs will down it inside the 10. San Diego State with a punt, and nice coverage on that. Backing them up, Sedsbury, another solid special teams play. 10:29 to go in the first half. We're tied 13-13 here on the Mountain West Network, powered by Campus Insiders.
Athleticism. I just think he's a solid, solid player.
This is what college football fans have been waiting for all season long.
San Diego State, the players certainly well aware this is going to be a competitive contest. Fans may be a little bit surprised how good Eastern Illinois has played.
Yeah, I don't think they were real familiar with the Ohio Valley Conference champion. And these guys have come in here and stood toe-to-toe. They've withstood some of their own mistakes, been able to bounce back from them, create their own big plays.
Well, Garoppolo and company going to start deep in the shadow of their own goalposts. And Duncan tries to take that one right up the middle and got hit hard. And the Aztec player, Jake Feely, slow getting up. And Feely, one of their star players on this defense for Rocky Long, unable to get back up.
Yeah, checking out that left ankle.
Him firing right in there. Sam Meredith, one of his own teammates, ended up behind him on the play.
Yeah, it was Feely that came in and made the initial hit. It was a great job on the play, and as the play ended, somebody fell into him on the backside. That's an unfortunate injury.
Yeah, that's Meredith falling right on top of him. You're right, and the play was long over. And second down and 8. They'll try it again. Safe handoff. And Duncan securing the ball. Duncan looking like he could play for Fisher DeBerry on that one. I mean, it's two hands on that. Your old coach at Air Force.
Oh, I know that too well.
Third and 4. 10 minutes to go, first half. Empty backfield on third down. Aztecs rush four. Garoppolo gets it out, incomplete. Gober was there, couldn't haul it in, would have been good for a first down.
Yeah, just a little quick out route. He had converted. He was past the sticks right there, but wasn't able to bring it in. Good job by Garoppolo. He put it right on that outside shoulder, right where he needed to.
Vizzy back for the Aztecs, and Gober and Garoppolo are figuring out where it went wrong.
Those are the types of plays when you go back and look at the tape on the next day, should the game end up shifting to San Diego State, that you're going to kick yourself for, because now they're kicking out of their end zone. San Diego State's going to have great ball position.
Weatherford gets the punt, turnover. And gambling on the return is Vizzy. They almost got the corner, couldn't quite get it. A lot of running for only a handful of yards.
Flag comes in there at the end.
As to be expected, we've had our fair share of penalties for the opening game of the season for both sides.
Yeah, we've seen a little bit of a mental mistakes, and we've seen some physical mistakes. And like you said, in week one, that's usually what you're going to get. You want to get these things ironed out. You come on the road like EIU, and you don't want to make those mistakes, though. It's tough enough to win.
Officials huddling. Here's Greg Burks.
Personal foul, number 23 of the receiving team. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Monte Kazee, the freshman, with a mistake that'll back up San Diego State even more, and Rocky Long doesn't tolerate foolish plays.
That falls into one of those mental categories that I was talking about. And then when you said freshman, that tells you right there. He's learning his lesson the hard way. What was ball position at midfield is now back inside the 35.
First down, they own 33. Play action. It'll dump out to the fullback, Young. And Young able to turn it upfield and get eight.
Well, I like it when I see the fullback slip out of the backfield, catch that ball out in the flat.
You have to have some reward. I mean, old fullback yourself, you can't just pound your head into that pile play after play, can you?
I hate to say it, but in Fisher to Berry's wishbone, yes, we did. There weren't a whole lot of passing plays for the fullback.
Second and two. Price alone back. Dingwell adjusting it at the line. Flags.
Yeah, movement down here. Looks like Roberts.
False start, number 73 offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Give it to Jordan Smith, the center.
You know, it's interesting, you see that fullback slip out there, and you see what's happening in the NFL right now. Really, the fullback is becoming extinct, and you're finding teams go more to the bigger tight end running that fullback role.
Play action on second and seven. Dingwell's pass is caught by Denso. He's covered up after a gain of three.
But in those great years when we had Terrell Davis with the Denver Broncos, our lead fullback was Howard Griffith, who was also a running back in college at the University of Illinois. And so he had the ball skills to catch the ball out in the flat, turn it up, make some yardage in the passing game. You just don't see that fullback anymore in the NFL. That role has really been turned over to the athletic, bigger tight end.
Third and four. Panthers showing pressure. And here they come. Dingwell gets it out, but behind Lockett. So the pressure of Eastern Illinois forces Dingwell's errant pass, fourth down.
Yeah, that's one thing that has surprised me a little bit here in the first half, Rich, is the ability for the Panthers to get some pressure on Dingwell on third down and force him to throw the ball before he's wanted to. There have been a number of instances here where the receiver's been open, but he hasn't been able to put the ball in the radius because he's had somebody in his face.
Little waiting near his 20. And Alisi. Oh, he got a foot into this one. And then Little retreating, makes the fair catch signal and hauls it in at the 8. 7:44 to go in the first half. Tied at 13. The Mountain West Network, powered by Campus Insiders.
Oh, they're making me laugh. Make my day. Oh, yeah, I got to do it all? Okay.
Okay.
I did forget that. Go ahead. Make my day.
Dino Babers on the left, second year head coach for Eastern Illinois, and Rocky Long on the right, third year head coach for San Diego State. Rocky has been around for a while.
He
head
has.
Coach at New Mexico, where he did a wonderful job leading that Lobo program. And I think Rocky's a guy who was just about happy to be a coordinator for the rest of his career. But when Brady Hoke left San Diego State to go to Michigan, Rocky was already on the staff, and they elevated him back to being a head coach here for the Aztecs, and a great hire for San Diego State.
It was the perfect move to hire from within.
Well, they had a good thing started, and he's been able to finish it. Three straight bowl games, conference championship last year for San Diego State, finishing 7-1. He is an outstanding coach.
You know, I'm such a big guy about building a culture within a program, and that's exactly what Rocky Long has done.
Little, back-to-back carries, gets out of the pile, first down up to the 25.
Tell you what, this Little's got a style that reminds you a little bit of Moema.
First down. Garoppolo to the air. Left sideline incomplete. Laura didn't even go up for that one. He was between defenders. That one too high.
Yeah, good job by the Aztec secondary right there. Safety coming over the top in support of the corner. Really, there was no place to go. Garoppolo put it where he should, which is way over on the sideline.
Well, Garoppolo's not afraid to live for another day. A little shovel pass. Little, we've seen that a number of times. Little going to get 9, 3rd-and-1 coming up. That Garoppolo, if it's not there, he just throws it to his sideline.
Yeah, I mean, that's what you got to do, is manage the football game and live to, like you said, play another down.
Well, they try the quick hitter on 3rd-and-1, and it's going to back him up.
5-yard penalty, 3rd down.
Yeah, I don't think they were set.
Nope, Goldberg gets the penalty, so now it's 3rd-and-1, 3rd-and-6. Aztec defense looking for a play, and the home crowd making a little noise. Garoppolo, Laura, catch. Spun around, fights, and lurches forward. It looks like the second effort is going to get him the first down.
Boy, I tell you, it's close.
Now they'll move him.
Yep, ball spotted over the 35-yard line. Aztecs came with an all-out blitz on the inside and then brought a corner off the edge as well, had man coverage.
First down, quick one. Laura looking to run, sheds a tackler, and then runs into three more black shirts and is knocked down.
You know, you look at the National Football League and the importance of that slot receiver and the guy that you can use to, you know, find the seams in defenses, work his way around the tough guy. Although he's going off the field right now, looks like he's a little bit of a ding. But Laura reminds you of the guys like Brandon Stokely and Wes Welker and that type of.
Second down and six, little run to the left, misdirection coming back to the right, and that fools nobody, and Shepard Little gets buried. 10 off the senior right there.
The thing about Laura too in that role is he brings a little more speed than even those guys have.
Third and nine. Garoppolo shifting, running, and throws it away.
Yeah, really no place to go with it at that time. Aztecs had everybody blanketed. Good job in the secondary. Fourth and nine. You know, early on, the Panthers took a couple shots downfield. Were able to match up with the corners man on man, but it's been a while since we've seen him try to stretch the defense.
Weatherford to punt. Vizzy back for the Aztecs. We got him spread out. That one will turn over, and Vizzy gets run into. Now, was that by his own man? No, I'm not so sure he didn't get run into by his own man trying to ward off one of the covermen. No flag down. Ball ends up out of bounds. We'll step aside. Aztec football when we come back. 5:15 to go in the first half on the Mountain West Network, powered by Campus Insiders.
I'm Bulldog born, Bulldog bred. I'm gonna be a Bulldog till the day I'm dead.
Boise, stay.
Live in fame or go down in flame. Nothing can stop the U.S. Air Force.
We are Spartan strong.
We will fight till victory. Go Aztecs.
Never yielding, never hell. A CSU Ram, I said I'm proud to be a CSU Ram.
When the pack goes marching in.
Oh, when the pack goes marching in.
Win with the Rebels of Scarlet and Gray. Rebels.
I believe that we will win. I believe that we will win.
He always sings ragged music to the cattle as he swings. Back and forth on the saddle, on the horse, a pretty good horse with a snake and pair of cat.
Another nice night in Southern California, down at the bottom of the state, San Diego, America's finest city, home of the San Diego State Aztecs, defending Mountain West champions a season ago, along with Boise State and Fresno State.
Better football players than they are singers.
Indeed they are. That is a fair statement. Didn't think you were going to go there, but you did. Lock it with the catch. And 5 minutes to go in the first half. Tie game.
Nice little quick out, just one-on-one, get the ball in Lockett's hand, see if he can make a little shifty move, perhaps turn a 5-yard gain into a 50-yard gain, but he was able to, the defender there was able to get a hand on him and trip him up.
Turn handoff, and Garrett, the sophomore, this time we've seen his number called, getting a carry. All right, the Panthers were ready.
Well, you mentioned it earlier. Both sides seem to have settled down a little bit. There have been a few penalties here and there that have forced some third and shorts into third and longs. But by and large, what I think of in the second quarter is the punters.
Right.
I mean, what a great job they've been able to flip the field.
They have. They've gotten the ball on a warm San Diego night to travel. And they've also got it to turn over each time. Haven't had a shank yet. Third and six. Dingwell steps into one. Vizzy catch. First down Aztecs.
Nice job finding the open Vizzy down at the bottom of the field here. Good throw. Watched it in. Caught it with his hands. It's exactly what you're looking for at the wideout position. Then tucked it away. Got upfield. Got some extra yards. Aztecs are moving.
And these are good opportunities for your offense with the things you're trying to get done as Dingwell steps into one. It floats and it looks like it's picked off. Trying to get it out there to Ruffin, and instead it's another interception for the Panthers. This one picked off by DJ Bland.
Looked like someone hit his hand or he hit his hand on a, no, right there, the ball. Reached out, the defender reached around, got a hand on the football right as he was releasing it. A little bit of the wounded duck effect right there. Receiver wasn't able to come back in time. They actually had the defender beat deep, but that's what allowed him to come back and make the interception.
Yeah, Ruffin was so far out in front of the defender, he couldn't come back and play defense and knock it down. So now the Panthers with the chance, and here comes pressure. There goes Garofalo looking deep. Got a man. Gober out in front, touchdown, Eastern Illinois, flipping things around.
Anything you can do, I can do better. Look at Garoppolo, takes the ball out of the shotgun, a little bit of a slow, low snap, puts it up, hits the receiver in stride. Once again, the Panthers take advantage of those young corners on the Aztec defense.
Well, and that's how you do it when you grab a turnover. Turn around and go for the big play. And the Panthers do, and they strike, and now they have the lead. PAT is blocked. Second missed PAT tonight for Eastern Illinois. 19-13 with 3:22 to go first half.
Oh, big block right there. 6-point game now. With two missed PATs, we're talking about an 8-point game. Again, those are the types of things that you expect early in the season, but you certainly don't want to have happen on the road. I mean, the Panthers have played such a great first half, but to miss these scoring opportunities, single points are going to matter in a game like this because San Diego can strike at any moment.
Well, Eastern Illinois is a game opponent, and all of the things that may have concerned Dino Babers, how would they react to being in an NFL stadium, how would the stage work for them. They have settled down, and they get an interception and then go for the home run ball and cash it in.
Well, that is the way you do it, too. It shows great confidence in your quarterback. Strike when the opponent is down. There was tremendous protection up there. He took the ball. It was a little bit of a low snap, but it didn't faze him one bit. He adjusted the ball in his hands, laid it up right over the shoulder there, hit the receiver in stride. And once again, the Aztecs are showing susceptibility on the corner.
Well, teams that come in as an underdog, especially on the road, the worst thing you could ever do is let them hang around and let them have confidence, and it's too late right now. Eastern Illinois realizes they can compete, score, and get some things done. They have a couple of turnovers. They've hit some big plays, and now the defense comes back out. Getting into a locker room on the road with a lead is a big plus.
Yeah, it's a huge plus, and a lot of confidence coming out in the second half. Both sides of the line, that's starting to jump out at me as well. The San Diego State Aztec defense is not pressuring Garoppolo. He's got a lot of time to sit back there and find his receivers. Yeah, they flushed him out a time or two here, but he's been smart with the football. And the defensive side has been able to create some pressure on the inside.
See what the Aztecs can do with 3:18 to go in the half. And now they're going to go deep with Ruffin throwing the pass. And he'll throw it out of bounds. Lockett was the intended target. Ruffin just misfired on his aim.
Well, again, a page out of the trickeration book. I'm not so sure at this particular point that I want Ruffin throwing the football. I think I'd have Dingwell leading the offense down the field. Whatever reason, there's not a lot of confidence right now on the San Diego State offensive side.
Second and 10. Hand off, Price shakes a tackler. And Price will make it third down and manageable.
Boy, he's got some shifty feet. Quick lower body.
LaQuick McCall. Gain of 5. Third down, 5 yards to go for the end.
Still 19-13. San Diego State, for confidence purposes and other purposes, needs to keep the ball away from Eastern Illinois for the rest of this half. The Panthers have shown they can score in a hurry. Dingwell on third down throws a bullet to Lockett, who had fallen down. Tough catch.
Yeah, good adjustment to the ball. He lost his footing, was actually down on his knees when he caught the football. Was able to convert. Aztecs are still moving.
Garrett in is the deep back. And Dingwell gonna send one deep. Incomplete. Ruffin couldn't come down with it. DJ Bland was out there with the coverage.
I'm not so sure Bland even knew where the football was at. Watch right here. Nice protection. Puts the ball up. He's just playing the receiver right now. He has no idea where the ball's at. That was close to a reach in.
Second down. Trying to set up a screen. And Pumphrey was in the backfield. Trying to leak out for the screen, but Dingwell really didn't have a chance. Too much pressure from the Panthers.
Yeah, edge pressure off the side right there. We're seeing a little bit more of that again in the second quarter. EIU's been able to break free. And I don't know if it's a communication problem between the line and the back, but it seems a couple times there's been a breakdown on the edge.
Similar play on third down and 10. And Price will make the catch, but won't get near enough for the first down, just 3.
Great job by Pete Houlihan, the right cornerback right there. Played off the block of the wide receiver, was able to close and trip up the ball carrier.
And fourth down for San Diego State. So Eastern Illinois wisely calls timeout with 1:48 to go.
Conserve a little bit of clock, give their quarterback Garoppolo a chance.
For all the good things they've done, the ones that, you know, concern you if you're an Eastern Illinois Panther is the 2 missed PATs.
The 2 missed PATs are 2 points that could play into the final score here, whether or not San Diego State has to go for 2 or have to score again on a field goal to end up winning the game. Right now with an 8-point or with a 6-point game, certainly they're in striking distance of winning. Had they made those 2 at 21-13, you'd force them a touchdown and a 2-point conversion. But the way things have been going, Rich, I'll be honest with you, I think we're going to see some more scoring in the second
agreed.
Half.
Agreed. It doesn't feel to me like offenses are slowing down. It feels to me like they're starting to speed up and really find their rhythm. Well, 4th and 7. And now here comes the punt team. I was saying, now really? Come on, Ted. They're not going to go for it on 4th and 7. I mean, Are they? Are they?
That would be pushing it a little bit, I think, early
can.
On right now.
Can you?
Yeah, a lot of people would say never punt on fourth down.
I know. I'm not sure I understand the mathematics behind it. But, no. Blocked punt. Oh, it's all going the Panthers' way right now. They got close to Elise last time. They get him this time and block the punt. Boy, those are big plays.
Boy, it wasn't one guy breaking through either. They had three guys break right through, straight up the gut.
Geiger Hill get it, 32, coming in. First down with 1:42 to go, so a timeout, and now a block punt.
They shot two guys through the A-gap on San Diego State's right side. And the up back on the right side had to make a decision whether to block inside or out, and you're always taught to block inside, the first guy to your inside. They ended up double-teaming that guy, which left the other defender wide open to come off the edge and make the block. That's a big play.
And a huge opportunity. And now you have a senior quarterback on the road. Garoppolo has settled in nicely. Last time out, he hit Gober for the big touchdown. Can they get more before halftime? Garoppolo pitch in underneath. Duncan will get 5 yards off the shovel pass. Clock moving. Two timeouts remaining for the Panthers.
Continuing to strike on that inside soft middle.
Garoppolo reaching up, making the catch. First down, ball pops out. And the Aztecs have it, and they're headed the other way. Pickens in the open field, still on his feet, looking for blockers. Now headed back the other way and finally knocked down. Laura got out there to cut him off, but it was a catch by Jeff LePack, who then had it knocked out and fumbled. San Diego State gets it back, 1:05 to go.
Well, they had the perfect play call right there. They had spread out the secondary, caught LePack underneath. He made the good catch. He's the biggest. Look at him outside right there. He's the biggest of them. You can see he doesn't quite run like a wide receiver. Didn't hold on to the football like one either.
Van S. Harris came in and stripped. Second time San Diego State has stripped a receiver from Eastern Illinois, taking the ball right away from him. Well, do the Aztecs go for the quick strike following the turnover?
Boy, I would. I would right now. I would test that secondary. I'd try to get Lockett manned up.
Two receivers each side going post pattern, caught by Lockett. Thinking the same way. Lockett stood up. Yeah, they're trying to pull the ball out of his arms. Unsuccessful, though. Well, stop the clock, it's first down.
They went to their big playmaker in Lockett, but he went on the little post right there, and there wasn't a whole lot of room once he caught the football to break open and free. That just wasn't the seam.
To the 28. Ball pops out. Picked up by the fullback, Young, who's going to turn the corner and then get knocked down. Nick Beer, the safety, came over showing his all OVC prowess. Big hit, but a heads-up play by Young to make something positive happen.
Well, who else would you want to have the football in their hands at that particular point in time in the fullback? Come on. No, it was a heads-up play. He was able to pick it up.
The Aztecs call a timeout.
He was able to pick it up and you know, saw that he had some open room, tried to make something happen, but most of the time you're taught, hey, just get down, we'll come back, run another play.
I mean, is the moisture coming in off the water? The ball's getting slippery. What's going on?
That was just a great play on the defensive side right there. That you teach the defensive ends to push that outside shoulder and then counter spin back in with that inside hand. That's exactly what he did. Great job by Pat Wirtz. 3 sacks a year ago, 53 total tackles, had 4 quarterback hurries. you can see why he was so productive. And that, again, that was a big-time play right there. Push that outside shoulder, and just as you feel that leverage start to give, come back on the inside, the quarterback had stepped up in the pocket, and Wirtz was right there to hit Dingwell.
41 seconds to go, first half. Eastern Illinois, 19-13. Eastern Illinois has had some really good seasons through the years. Last year, a comeback from worst the year before to first place finish, and another talented team this year. Second and 12 for San Diego State. Dingwell running out of time. Finds an open Vizzy left side with room. And Vizzy powers his way inside the five.
I think Vizzy was a check down there. He was wanting to go deep. He's looking downfield, One, two. Sees Vizzy crossing over wide open. And that's what you got to do.
On first and goal, rollout, toss back in the end zone, incomplete. Almost intercepted. McNulty was right there.
Just for a second, it looked like he had him in the back of the end zone open. But Vizzy did a great job on that last play of catching the ball and just getting upfield as quickly as he possibly could.
Still waiting for the play to come in. Play clock down to 10. 4-3-2. They get it off. Pressure. Caught and throwing it through the back of the end zone wisely. And they'll live to play again.
You saw the strength of Dingwell right there, Rich. That was a great job. I mean, he's got a defender on his lower body right there trying to drag him down. He was able to stay on his feet. The arm strength to throw it out of the back of the end zone. Not take the sack, not take the loss. The clock stops. Good job by Dingwell.
Third and goal. Pressure again. Dingwell gets it off, incomplete. Broken up by Wickliffe. He stepped in front.
EIU had blitz off of both edges.
Broken up by number two, Jordan Wickliffe.
And Fear going to come on and try to knock through his third field goal of the half. That's the smart move for the Aztecs.
Yeah, it really is. Take the points now.
Fourth down.
A good job by Eastern Illinois stiffening up down here in the red zone.
Timeout, Panthers.
I
have a feeling that since you have a couple timeouts remaining, now they're down to one, that if I'm playing a Bob Toledo coached offensive team, that I would just remind my guys to make sure they kick it. I don't think we're going to block it here. It's close. Make sure they kick it. Let's not give them six on this. Let's make sure they, if they get anything, it's only the three.
Yeah, they've already gone too deep on that particular play board. I'm sure Bob's got one in this,
of course,
in this situation. But that's a good job by the coaching staff. Again, that's another thing, and we should bring that up, Rich, is that this is the first game for the coaching staff as well.
Sure.
They've got to make these types of decisions, be put in these types of scenarios, and make sure they're communicating back and forth. That may have come down from the top. So good job by the EIU staff right there. Bring them back over, remind them there's still time left on the clock. Make sure the kick is made. Hold them to three.
23-yard attempt. Ball's down. And Fear remains perfect.
22 yards.
19-16.
Well, it's a good score for the Aztecs. They cut it to 3 points, a field goal. But I tell you what, in that particular situation, I almost got to give the win to the Panthers.
Agreed.
They stiffened up down there on defense. They made some good plays, brought, you know, made a couple risks, brought some pressure via the blitz, left it up to their defenders to make a play one-on-one, and they were able to do that.
Well, a sudden change off the turnover. And all of a sudden, if you're Eastern Illinois, you're thinking it's, you know, goal to go from the five. We could end up going in the locker room down. Yet, you know, even with all that's happened here on the road, opening game, looking at hold on for the next 16 seconds, hold on to the ball, you go to locker room at halftime up by three.
I think you hit the nail on the head. It is a learning experience that they are going to take from this week into that Ohio Valley Conference schedule. These are things that it's great that they're happening right now, because sometimes they don't happen until week eight, and it's too late then.
And, you know, we've seen this a lot through the years. You think of the teams that everything goes your way throughout the start of the season, and then a little adversity hits, and we've seen more than one team come unraveled through the rest of the season when you haven't been challenged. And fierce kick, returnable.
From the three.
And Pendergrass pops up. 10 seconds to go, first half.
Yeah, again, we can't say enough about both coaching staff, but right now, Coach Babers to bring in this EIU squad into the queue against San Diego State, one of the better teams in the Mountain West Conference, pick number two in the West, to stand toe-to-toe with these guys like they have, to withstand some mistakes that they've made themselves. And they're going in the locker room with a lead.
We are heading into the half.
And the final seconds tick off the clock, and Eastern Illinois leading San Diego State at halftime, 19-16. Halftime at Qualcomm. Aztecs will head to their locker room and try to sort some things out in an entertaining first half. You're watching Mountain West Football on the Mountain West Network, powered by Campus Insiders.